Hi, I'm Torben Jansen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a question about ordering of null values. But before we dive deeper, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified about new Hibernate tip videos. I upload new videos every week. Here's today's question. I need to order the result of a JPQL query based on a column that contains null values. How can I define how null values shall be handled? The handling of null values while ordering your query result is harder and at the same time simpler than you might expect. The JPA specification defines that during ordering, null values shall be handled in the same way as determined by the SQL standard. The standard specifies that all null values shall be returned before or after all non-null values. It's up to the database to pick one of the two options. That makes the handling of null values more or less undefined. The SQL standard fixed that by introducing null's first and null's last clauses, which enable you to define the position of null values. Unfortunately, the JPA standard doesn't support these clauses, but most JPA implementations, including Hibernate, support them anyway, and there is a request to add them to the JPA specification. Let's take a look at two Hibernate examples that use these clauses. Here you can see a query that selects all book entities in the descending order of their publishing date and puts null values first. As you can see in the log messages, Hibernate generates an SQL query using a null's first clause. And you can, of course, replace the null's first with the null's last clause to change the position of records containing null values. As you can see here, Hibernate now generates an SQL query using a null's last clause. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!